The lamb could not get born. Ice wind out of a downpour, dishclout sunrise. The mother lay on the muddied slope. Harried, she got up, and the blackish lump bobbed at her back end under her tail. After some hard galloping, some manoeuvring, much flapping of the backward lump head of the lamb looking out, I caught her with a rope, laid her head uphill, and examined the lamb. A blood ball, swollen tight in its black felt, its mouth gaps quashed crooked, tongue stuck out, black-purple, strangled by its mother. I felt inside, past the noose of mother flesh, into the slippery, muscled tunnel, fingering for a hoof, right back to the porthole of the pelvis, but there was no hoof. He had stuck his head out too early, and his feet could not follow. He should have felt his way, tiptoe, his toes tucked up under his nose for a safe landing. So I kneeled, wrestling with her groans. No hand could squeeze past the lamb's neck into her interior to hook a knee. I roped that baby head and hauled till she cried out and tried to get up, and I saw it was useless. I went 2 miles for the injection and a razor. Sliced the lamb's throat strings, levered with a knife between the vertebrae, and brought the head off to stare at its mother, its pipe sitting in the mud, with all earth for a body. Then pushed the neck stump right back in, and as I pushed, she pushed. She pushed crying, and I pushed gasping. And the strength of the birth push and the push of my thumb against that wobbly vertebra were deadlock, a to-fro futility, till I forced a hand past and got a knee. Then, like pulling myself to the ceiling, with one finger hooked in a loop, timing my effort to her birth push groans, I pulled against the corpse that would not come. Till it came. And after it, the long, sudden, yolk-yellow parcel of life, in a smoking slither of oils and soups and syrups, and the body lay born beside the hacked-off head.